So the radioactive decay law. So this itself gives us the biggest clue here. Decay. So we all know what is the physical meaning of decay, correct? So here, according to this particular law, the rate of disintegration of radioactive atoms is directly proportional to the number of radioactive atoms present. Okay. So I'll tell you a very simple thing. So let n be the number of atoms present here. Rate of disintegration. Whenever we hear the word rate. Okay, in max also we got rate. Rate in the sense d by dx. That's it. Here with respect to time. So I will write what? D by dt. N be the number of radioactive atoms. So that is proportional to n itself. So whenever you get rate in the question, d by dx, or here with it is with respect to time. So d by dt and n proportional to n. That's it. Suppose if I want to make it, I'd remove this proportionality symbol. A simple thing I had to do, that is, I'll write the same thing, d by dt of n. Correct? This particular thing. So that is dn by dt equal to lambda n, where lambda is called the decay constant. Where this lambda is the decay constant. So again in max, I think in application of derivatives, I think so in the chapter, you got something called rate. This particular thing. Rate means d by dt. Immediately differentiation should come. That's it. Okay. And one more thing, so which I'll be teaching in the logarithmic part. Suppose if it is undecayed sample. Undecayed sample. So what will be our, according to this law? It will be n is equal to n naught e power minus lambda t. Okay. So here for an undecayed sample, number of radioactive atoms present. Correct. And this is for the time t is equal to 0. At t is equal to 0, n is equal to n naught. That's it. Okay. So that I'm not going to write here. Then comes our half-life. Very, very important. But for entrance, we need not even use these formulas. Whatever I'm writing now for the entrance, without the formulas itself, we can get it through common sense. So currently, I'm just writing everything, correct? So what is the meaning of half-life of a radioactive element? So everything is with respect to radioactivity, okay? So which means the time in which only half number of radioactive atoms present after the sample decay. So when the decay happens, and if I have 50% of the atoms remaining, that is called half life. So this is called half life. And here a simple formula we have to use: time period T is equal to 0.693 by lambda. In board exam, we have to use this. Entrance, nothing is required. Direct application of one more thing is there by using common sense. Next important topic is average life or mean life. Okay. So this is nothing but it is a ratio of the ratio of total lifetime of all atoms and the total number of atoms initially present in the sample. Okay, that's it. So this is not that important. So if you want to write the definition of this, the best way to remember this: mean life, TM. Correct? You write down like this: total life of all atoms. Correct? To the total number of atoms. So this will be much more simple for you. Total number of atoms. Rather than studying the definition, this is much more easier for us. So this is standard thing, not required. This will be more than fine for us. Then comes one important topic. They'll ask you, what is activity? What is activity of a radioactive element? They can ask you this question. So this is equal to what? To its disintegration. So activity is represented by R. This is equal to minus dN by dt. If you ask me what is minus dN by dt, dN by dt represents the rate of disintegration. So activity of an radioactive element is equal to what? Its rate of, so this is equal to, you can write this one, rate of disintegration. Fine. dN by dt represents, dN by dt represents the rate of disintegration. Activity of an element, activity of a radioactive element is equal to the rate of disintegration. So activity is represented by R. So I'll write down here. Activity R is equal to minus dN by dt. So we should be focused on this one. This one is our main focus here. Okay. And then one more question in one mark, which is every time they will ask is, what is the unit of activity? almost in all the paper we can see this one marker. Radioactivity in the sense I told you, Henri Becquerel. So the answer of this is what? Becquerel. BQ or Becquerel. That's it. Then comes our nuclear fission reaction. So which means splitting of a fission, in the sense fission is there, and one more thing is nuclear fusion. Fusion. Fusion means combining, correct? Or combination. So we have to remember, if you remember these terms like this, it's easy for us. Fission means splitting. Correct. So splitting of, what is it? Splitting of a heavy nucleus, correct, into two or more lighter nuclei. So for example, I'll just draw it and give to you, then it's very easy for you guys. This is a one big nuclei. Okay, so this is splitting up into two parts. Two lighter nuclei will split off. And this again will split into other two. Correct? So this is a heavier nucleus or nuclei or whatever it is. And this is our lighter nuclei. Lighter nuclei. Number one is this, number two is this. Correct? Fusion is nothing but the reverse of this. In fusion, what will happen? I'll draw that also. In nuclear fusion. So this is the nuclear number one, this is number two. This will join. This together will join to give a bigger nucleus. That is this. Correct. I'll get a heavy nucleus in this. So for the definition's sake, what is it? Splitting of heavy nucleus into two or more lighter nuclei. That's it. For definition's sake, I can just write it for you. Splitting of heavier nucleus into lighter nuclei into two or more. That's very important. Okay. Either it can be two minimum or more into two or more lighter nuclei. Currently given here two. But actually it can be what, more than two also. So where do we apply this nuclear fission? Correct. In a nuclear reactor. So that is the main application of what? Nuclear fission. Number one, it is applying the nuclear fission reaction. So I'll explain very clearly how it is. So why we need a, we have to know why we need this thing. Power. Power for what? To generate electricity. That's it. We need this nuclear reaction. Now how? So for that I'll draw a box now. So one more small box I will draw inside this. and this outer surface, correct? This is actually made of steel, thick steel. Okay, this is mainly for the shielding purpose. So this control rods which are drawn here, right? It is mainly made up of uranium, plutonium, radioactive materials. Correct? Uranium and plutonium coated in graphite. Fine. Okay. Control rods, I can also say it is a fuel rods. So maybe in some reactors, control rods and fuel rods are same. So this can be also the fuel rods, because only from this we are able to generate electricity, or else in sometimes control rods can be graphite also. Okay. And what happens in a fission reaction is, correct? So this is nuclear fission. So which means neutrons, correct? The nucleus is getting splitted. So what happens from this fast moving neutrons? Neutrons will be hitting here, correct? Yes or no? So there will be very fast moving neutrons emitted from this fuel rods or the control rods. Correct. So large amount of power will be there. And if we want to see, these kind of reactors will be actually in the middle of an ocean or some kind of thing. Because end of the day, how do we produce electricity? What happens? Large amount of this power, water is continuously supplied through this. Okay. So what happens is that due to this kind of energy produced, this water, this will be converted to steam. This water will be what? This cold water from the ocean will be converted to steam. And then this steam, this power, this steam will be connected to a turbine. So which means this steam will rotate the turbine. Correct? And from the turbine, it is connected to a generator. So what happens? Mechanical energy is converted to electrical energy. So that's how this works. So continuous supply of ocean water. And this ocean water is what? It's coolant. This also helps us to, this continuous recycling of this ocean water will help us, help the nuclear reactor be cool. Correct? Coolant. So coolant as well as moderator. Moderator or coolant, both. Both we use it as what? Heavy water, because it is cheap. And plenty it is available because it is in the ocean. But end of the day, what do you have to focus? The energy coming out, correct? So what happens? The water is evaporated due to this particular thing. What happens? The water is evaporated to steam, and this steam is supplied through a pipe to run the turbine, correct? And this turbine in the sense what? Mechanical energy is produced in the turbine. So this mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy with respect to a generator. And hence we get the electricity through this. Correct. So here fuel rods are uranium or plutonium. Control rods also may be the same, or else they use graphite. Okay. But the problem is with the graphite is we have to replace it. The carbon. Graphite is obviously the carbon, so we have to replace it. So that is a disadvantage. So mostly nowadays, everyone is using uranium and plutonium only as the control rods. Okay, fine. And what happens due to the nuclear fission process? Lot of neutrons are being emitted. Correct, fast moving neutrons. What happens? This neutron should bounce back inside this wall. That's the reason this wall is a thick wall. This outer wall is a very thick wall. Correct. And continuously water is supplied to this. Fine, through a pump. So I not drawn all the thing, but I want to make sure that you understand what is the process. And nuclear fusion is just the opposite of this. Two lighter nuclei. See here, heavier nucleus to two lighter nuclei. Here, two lighter nuclei to heavier nucleus. What is the best example of this? Hydrogen bomb. That is the, I think everyone will be very familiar with this, nuclear fusion. Correct? And one more thing is at sun. sun, what is happening? Nuclear fusion. The source of sun's energy is what? The source of sun's energy is nuclear fusion, respectively. Another one is hydrogen bomb, is nuclear fusion. Okay. So the energy released from the nuclear fusion reaction is called thermonuclear energy. That's it. So this we have to study. And one more thing, I told you in nuclear fission, what is their fast moving neutrons? So neutrons are, one more thing is, neutrons are mainly used in where? In fission process, and protons in fusion process. So if we can study like this, it'll be very easy for us to remember. So each and everything study in diagrammatic way, correct? Rate in the sense differentiation should be used, put in box,